Hello again, this is Jabba here, and it's been a while since the last time we did a live stream in relation to DAZ Studio stuff, but here we are again. Right, and what I'm looking at today is using the motion blur in your render settings to actually offer like a soft halo effect. So it's a bit like trying to do a special effect in your render rather than doing it in post-work. There are products that are in the DAZ store that can offer something similar, you know, perhaps Jeep's graphics being applied to a plane or Sickle Yields, Easy God Rays, Simple God Rays. It's a similar sort of principle, but you can use those products and use this motion blur technique to perhaps soften them up even more if you're wanting them softened. But I'm not going to. I'm specifically not going to use any products that need purchase today, just to prove the point of the technique in using the motion blur. That having been said, we'll quickly do a transmap in the GIMP. So if we go into GIMP, new 1024 by 1024, that's good. Image and window. Right, now for this example, let's fill it in black. Put the foreground colour. Right, because in DAZ Studio, when we're talking transparency settings, transmaps, then black is completely see-through, completely transparent, and white is completely solid, you know, completely visible in your render. Shades of grey in between have various degrees, you know, so the darker it is, the more see-through it's going to be, you know, the more transparent, and the lighter it is, the closer to white that it is, then the more solid it will appear, you know, the more visible it will be. Now, for this particular example, so we'll just keep this nice and simple. We'll just work in black and white. So, we'll use a star. Okay. Right, I'll maybe make it smaller. Smaller, yeah, perhaps. Yeah, okay, right. Maybe we want, hang on, we've got the brush. We're white, we're on, right, we're game on, right. Okay, let's just do something simple to begin with. Just approximate a circle of stars, say. Maybe we want some alternate items in here as well. Let's up this a bit. Okay, let's... And no. Okay. Let's just keep it simple. Right. Okay. So this we'll just simply save this. Export as. Right, so this is already in a location that I want it to go into. So obviously save it where you can find it easily inside DAZ Studio. I'll just say this is 123. And whatever those default settings are, that's fine with me. Okay. Now inside DAZ Studio, this could be a halo, you know, like for instance a halo behind someone's head, so you've got a holy image. It could be something more exotic, you know, something more fantasy, you know, a glowing orb, and you want to give the impression that light's radiating out from it, so you know, that sort of thing. Now, sometimes it's easy to do that in post-work, sometimes, depending on the scene, sometimes it can be quite awkward. You know, or perhaps you've done your renders, you know, it's like you've been flattening layers, and you realise that, I should have really done that in render, you know, or if only I could have done it in render. Well, if you're planning ahead, then this is the sort of thing that you could possibly realise is something that you can factor in, you know, in actual planning. Right, I'm sorry, before I move that around, it would help if I added the things to the scene. Right, so just to keep this simple, we'll just use our default Genesis dude, and I add a couple of elements. So, let's see, a plane, yeah, a meter will do, and we need a camera as well. Right, we specifically need to add a camera, or at least just for the technique I'm doing today. Right, now the plane, let's just put this around about the middle of the head. Camera one, where do we want camera one? Oh well, let's just do camera one from the front. It'll keep things a bit easier for this example. Although that having been said, it's not that I'm... No, I said keep it from the front, didn't I? Right, yeah, just something like that, right. You know, so the idea here is this is going to be some sort of halo around the head, this one. So the plane, if we go into the parameter settings, and we point it at the camera, point it at camera one, right. So there, bash, right, we've got it pointing at the camera. So what we can do now, I'm just running my circles. Scoot that to the left a bit. Just, oh, okay. Right, so we see there it's pointing at the camera. Now, in order for this to work, we now need to move this plane. Well, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll add the transmap before we do anything else to it, just so you can see, because this doesn't make sense with just the plane. So if I perhaps go to the surfaces setting of the plane, the opacity, strength, if I add the transmap that we made. Now, if we look at the plane up close, you'll now see that plane is now the stars and dots that we did inside GIMP. Okay. So what we want to be doing with this is to get that halo effect, that softness. We want to be moving it. So this is where the timeline plays its part. So here we want to be okay. Let's take it back a bit more. Okay, that's going to be fine, he says confidently. Okay, now take it up to frame 5 and bring this back up to right. Now, if we do not want it interfering with the render of the clothes and stuff, then stop it before. You know, or if we go beyond, then you will get an interesting effect as it passes through. But just for this particular example, let's leave it there. Um, Now, you see, if we position this at different points, we'll see the movement. Now, just for this example, I'll use frame 4. Now, in the render settings, in your advanced render settings, this is motion blur needs to be selected. Motion samples 2, I think that's a default, and that's pretty much what I use anyway when I do this stuff. Now, the idea behind not going to actual frame 5 is that this keeps it soft at both the start and the end. It's like, if it was at the start, the easiest thing I can do is render this just to show you. You see, it's like, it's not, you know, it's not doing much good for us. If it's at 5, then we're not getting any motion because it's at the extreme where it's kind of like turning back again. You know, this is where it stops. So if we actually go to number 4, however, see, then we've got it in motion from frame 0 up to frame 4, but we've also got the frame 5 back to 4 happening, so that we don't have the extremities sharp. See there that I've actually. Be interesting. This will be very interesting. Yep. Okay, just. So this is me just being a bit of a pedant. Okay, we'll just leave it there. It's just a quick example. Obviously, in your scene, you know, it's like you get the pattern you want right, you get the positionings just right, all that sort of stuff. Now again, in the plane, if we go to our ambient, and you know, let's just colour it yellow. You know, just so that it's nice and bright. You know, just so you can see it in the diffuse. That's basically the principle behind it. Now, if I reposition, it's particularly in front, like that. So you'll see how here. Side by side. See, it's because there's more distance being travelled. We're getting the. Well, when I'm saying halo, it's more like a wormhole effect here, isn't it? But certainly, if we'd done a circular design inside. Yes, indeed. But here, because it's more extreme, plus we're getting bleed over in front of the figure. Which can be a very nice effect in itself as well. Okay, I've just had an idea. Let's go back into the GIMP. I'm not too sure about this. Maybe I should make this smaller. I'm never very good with a slider. But there, I must admit, I usually use Photoshop. But that's. but the whole point is, this is everything you can do for absolutely free. You know, so like I'm saying, there are products available, but that in itself doesn't mean that products have to be bought. If you're inventive enough, you can actually make your own thing. Right. So here we've got it's like absolutely atrocious. But what the hell. I've got a better idea actually. Maybe I should just do it like this. Which I've got the. Just use the hard brush. Yay! Right, and reduce the size a bit. That'll do. Obviously, it's I must admit, I would kind of normally work in layers. But just for argument's sake, let's do it like this. Right, so if I save this again, and export this as 456. Right, now if we go to the plane and go to the opacity, if we change out this map for 456. Right. Now we're talking Halo. Right, no. If I was to go frame 5 again. Move this to behind. Not at least so that it's not, so it's not in front of the Oops. I meant to go back to frame 4. Alright, so there we have, not quite as... Well, as you can see, definitely off-center, but So there, it's we don't have it in front. But you see, that's the thing, it's worth experimenting with. And that can give a rather interesting effect. And I think I'll just leave it there for the time being. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Cheery bye.